Welcome back to Final Cut Pro 10.1 in depth. We're now going to look at how to update your Final Cut Pro projects and events. If you're using legacy Final Cut Pro 10.0.9 and earlier, you are going to want to pay close attention to what Mark is going to show you in this particular lesson.
Yeah, absolutely, Steve. Thanks. And especially, this whole tutorial is pretty much designed for people who have been using Final Cut Pro 10 previous versions. And there's some kind of big changes that folks need to know about. And I think the very first thing is this, that you need to be running Mavericks.
Mavericks, the new operating system.
Yeah, the new operating system. Right. Yeah, so that's kind of a big deal because Mavericks, coming out pretty much the same time, right around the same time as Final Cut Pro 10.1, a lot of folks aren't going to be on it yet. And if you're anxious to upgrade to 10.1, you need to hold it. First, you need to be running Mavericks. So you have to go through and see if your system supports Mavericks. You have to go to the Apple website and see the system requirements. Like, I have an old Mac Pro, not the brand new Mac Pro, but I have one of the old Mac Pros, and I can't run Mavericks on that. So you need to check out what's supported and get up on Mavericks. And so we should talk a little about why. Like, why is this the case? Apple's generally designing toward the future, and they really built Final Cut in a way to take advantage of the newest operating system, and that's why they did this. So the theme of this whole thing is about performance and workflow improvements, and really to get the most performance out of Final Cut 10.1, they built it on the foundation of Mavericks. So specifically, there's a couple little things in here. There's a lot of things under the hood, but there's a couple of features that Mavericks has that Final Cut Pro can take advantage of. For instance, there's these features called timer, coalescing, and compressed memory are two of those features.
Your CPU is always doing these low-level tasks in the background. It's always working. So timer coalescing, simply what it does is takes those low-level tasks and it coalesces them into a group so that the CPU isn't having to deal with all those tasks at once. So basically you get better battery performance.
Yeah, so instead of it constantly looking for and doing tasks, it bundles them together, does them all at once, and then has a lot of downtime.
That's right.
So it's more efficient. And then the compressed memory?
Yes, compressed memory is also very important. You think about it, as an editor, you're running a lot of apps at the same time. So what this does is it looks at what's running and what's not running, and all the apps that aren't running, it puts it in.
It frees up that memory. It literally compresses that memory, creating more memory available for Final Cut. So a couple features there. There's also some features built into Mavericks that isn't under the hood. There's a specific feature we use, like multiple displays, because now you can have multiple displays that each have their own menu bar.
Oh, that's huge.
Plus, you've got Air Display, so you can send your Final Cut Pro interface to HDTV or any Air Display connected device. So a couple nice things there. And then there's these interactive notifications that Final Cut takes advantage of. So it'll give you notifications about what's going on in Final Cut. Like this job is completed. This share export is completed. So it's actually some useful parts
in there. So it basically
tells
you what's going on with Final Cut when you're working.
Yeah, and you can actually respond to those notifications.
Right. Okay.
So here's the thing. When you first launch 10.1, you're going to get this dialog box. And the dialog box is going to say, hey, Final Cut libraries contain all your projects and events, and it's going to ask you to update. So what is that about? This can be confusing if you see this for the first time. Like, what are you talking about? So before we even get into updating, I want to explain this thing about Final Cut's libraries, because Final Cut Pro 10.1 really has a new unified library model.
So much cleaner, so much simpler. So much more organized than the previous version of Final Cut Pro.
It really simplifies a lot of media management tasks, how you organize projects, how you work with projects, how you share projects. So we're not going to get into detail about that here, but I just want to lay out the basic idea of what libraries are in 10.1 and how they work. So if we look historically, between the new 10.1 and previous versions, 10.0.x, meaning 10.0.9 and earlier, in the earlier versions of Final Cut Pro 10, we had an event library and a project library, right?
There's two separate things. Libraries.
Yeah. Event library up top, project library down below. Two completely separate things. The event library has all our media, right? And our project library was all the timelines that you'd scroll through and choose them. So here's the big difference now. In 10.1, there's a single unified library that contains both those things together.
All right. Your events and your projects.
Your events and your projects. So all of that goes into a library that all contain. Now, you can have multiple libraries. So when I say unified library, I don't mean
a single library, monolithic library.
Yeah, but what that means, here's specifically what it means, is that library, each library that you have, not only contains events like you may be used to, but it also contains the media and the projects associated with those events. okay, which is a fundamental change in how Final Cut organizes your material, your clips, your projects, your events, all into this thing. Let's actually take a look how this looks in Final Cut Pro 10.1. So here I have the full Final Cut Pro 10.1 interface, and if we zoom up to the top left corner, we can see that we've got libraries here. Okay, represented by this little tile of the
little four-star tile. By the way, those stars indicate events. So like, because events are stored within libraries, you have a multi
Right, kind of a so you can see, event. In fact, you can see events stored within libraries, which is kind of what we're used to. Nothing really new there. But now, within an event, we see both the projects associated with that event and the clips associated with the event. So projects now move up into this library up here. And there's no more project library down below. So that's kind of the key change.
Big change.
Yeah. And I know this can sound confusing at first. What's going on? It's really smart. It works really well. Just hang in there, because we're going to talk a lot more about libraries throughout this tutorial and how to work with them. But that's just a little bit to kind of get you set up on how it works. So make sense so far?
Makes complete sense.
Okay. So you're gonna get this dialog box. It says update because you've got this new unified library model. Now, you can go ahead and just click update. Before we come back to it, we recommend there's a couple things that you should do in order to get ready for the update process.
Kind of like a pre-flight check to upgrading.
Yeah, and what it really amounts is some housekeeping.
Yeah.
And it's not required at all, but we recommend it because we've been through this a bunch of times and kind of see where you get tripped up, and so we think this will help you. So we're calling this cleaning up your projects and events, because it really is just a little bit of housekeeping. So first is re-enabling your projects and events. The second one is relinking your files. Again, optional pieces, but let's see how they work. So let's talk about the first one, re-enabling projects and events. So a lot of you guys might use Event Manager. You use Event Manager 10?
Excellent piece of software.
Yeah, great for managing which projects and events are actually show up in Final Cut 10, right? So I'm going to switch over to it right here. I've got it running right here. And the thing about Event Manager 10 is it allows you to turn on specific events and specific projects. What we're recommending here is that you turn everything on that you want to have updated.
And, and conversely, the things you don't want updated,
turn them off. If for some reason you didn't want to update, you can turn them off. Now, if you still want access to stuff in earlier versions of Final Cut 10 for some reason, you can do that even when you update. So really, what we like to do is basically go in here and turn everything on that you want to have updated. That's kind of number one, is getting everything turned on so it appears in Final Cut Pro 10. This also applies to any connected drives that may be disconnected, right, that have
projects
and events
on them. Right, if you want to update, you want to connect those drives.
Those should be connected. Otherwise, they're not going to get updated, clearly, because they're not connected.
That's right.
It's pretty straightforward, okay? So that's really the first step one here, is to re-enable your projects and events so you can see them. Whether you use Event Manager 10 or you may just drag them out manually.
I did that for a while before Event Manager.
Yeah, exactly. Just drag those things back in. So the second thing is relinking event files. And here's what I mean by that. So here we are in Final Cut Pro 10.0.9. And I have this disk image with some events and some projects here. So right away, I can see there's an exclamation point next to this event, which tells us
something's offline.
Something's offline, right. So the first kind of spot check is to go through and fix anything that comes up like that. So here I have a clip that's offline. It says missing file. So what I would do with that event selected, choose File, Relink Event Files, and navigate. I'll bring up the dialog box. Navigate to where that thing is.
And relink it, right? Which we're not going to do now.
No, we're not going to do it because I want to see what happens if you don't.
Right, that's a good point, because some people won't relink files. But what happens?
And honestly, the first time through, I just updated everything. And then I started to understand, okay, some stuff's offline because it was offline before.
Right.
So if I clean up first, everything will be good. So that's a great thing to do, but it's not really enough. Because even if all these events don't have exclamation points, you could still have clips in projects that come from events that aren't currently
online. Let me just interject something. This is why I think the old model of having a separate project library and a separate event library was very confusing.
Yes,
because you'd end up, you had two separate entities that kind of related but didn't relate. It was it created
and
a mess.
And that's going to go away. And you'll get this because it combines, it's still extremely flexible, but it keeps track of everything. Mm-hmm. So for example, here in this Quintessa Charles project, we can see down here, it's not a missing clip, it says missing event. So there's actually a clip in this project.
That's looking for an event that's not online.
It's looking for an event that's not there. Uh-huh. So in this case, I'd want to make sure that event, it's not in your event folder in your Finder.
Sure.
So you'd want to fix that. To get some help with that, with the project selected, you can go to the inspector and find the name of the missing event. So that's the sort of second part of cleaning things up.
But you're not going to fix it.
I'm not going to fix it again to see what happens. Okay, so that's really the key things to clean up, okay? To get ready. And it could take a little while if you've got a lot of offline media to clean up, if you haven't been really fastidious, you know, historically to get things cleaned up. But generally, you get everything set up. And once you've done that, there's three things I recommend you do once everything's cleaned up. And the first is, if you do want to access those project and events in earlier versions, go back them up.
Why would I want to do that? But yeah, I guess
you could. Yeah, you know, if you felt for some reason you went to Final Cut 10.1, you still needed somebody else's on 10.0.9, and you wanted them to have it, back them up. Just put them on another drive. And if you forget to do it now, you'll still have an opportunity
still
to do it.
Still one more chance during the update process.
During that press. So, but that would be one good thing to do. Another good thing that we recommend anytime you update is to archive the previous version of the app.
Because of sandboxing, you can just archive the app, put it somewhere, and it still works later if you want to extract it and install it.
Exactly. It really works beautifully. So if I just go to the Finder here, and I'll go to Applications, and I'll just type FIN, so I'll get to Final Cut. There it is, Final Cut Pro. I'll right-click or control-click and choose Compress. And that will take and zip up the application in a compressed file, then just throw it in a folder.
And then you can trash that Final Cut Pro, which, by the way, something we recommend. Correct?
Yeah, you can get rid of it because you could always bring it back. Yeah. You could always bring it back afterwards. So once you've done that, you've backed up your projects, you've archived, you know, time to go for it. If you're on Mavericks, you've done a little bit of prep work, you're ready to download 10.1 and get to work and get it updating. So that's the background. So in the next part of this lesson, we'll go into how to actually do the update.
Excellent. So this is kind of a preamble, as it were, to everything you need to do prior to actually clicking the button, update. And you don't have to be scared.
And by the way, the update is super fast. I mean, you're 90% of the way done. The update's just quick. But we'll explain exactly what happens in that process.
And so we'll do that in the next lesson.